And now, The Bonfire with Big J. Okerson and Dan Soder.
Just let the whole song play.
It's whole song. Do the whole song.
Is this a 2 hour rendition?
Yeah. 1 hour and 57 minutes of just working, man.
Just
from
let it
Rush.
Run through commercials.
That's like when radio stations get formats flipped.
Yeah.
They just play like a song, or they'll like start playing a song. We're like, why is this just playing?
In one minute, it just changes?
Yeah, like at midnight, it'll switch, and then all of a sudden, it's just playing a song, and then people are like, why does this keep playing? And then they're like, tomorrow, we're a Spanish news station.
I did Man Cow one day, and the next day, it turned to Christian rock, they said.
Yeah.
I did Man Cow in Chicago.
Yeah.
Where's Man Cow now? I'm trying to deflect. Let's do a deep dive on Man Cow now.
Let's bring up someone else. Let's talk about someone else. Yeah, it's a shitty day. Welcome to Bonfire, SiriusXM Faction Talk 103. I'm Dan Soder. That's Big J. Okerson. Full crew, DJ Lou, Christine, Jacob, and our Black King, the Black Tiger, Lewis Johnson.
This should have been a booze day, guys.
I mean,
someone should get booze.
You would have got me to drink.
Can we get booze? Can anyone get booze? Can we get booze delivery? Would that look bad?
Yeah. I don't know if we'd be able to do it that fast.
Well, where's all the campaign?
We're so good at just fucking cutting around and beating around the bush that I think we might as well just talk to it and just fucking, you know?
Yeah. Yeah.
So on March 1st will be my last day on the show. I'm going to be leaving.
That was a Band-Aid rip. Jesus H. Christ.
I told you, dude, I was going to rip it. But March 1st is going to be my last day on the Bonfire. However, the Bonfire will continue with Big J and... Bobby Kelly
is Robert Kelly. Bobby Kelly is going to jump in.
Which I can't now. I did just rip the Band-Aid, so we got to go and talk a lot about it.
I thought we were going to have a dramatic build-up.
I don't know. I'm bad at this. I don't know. I just wanted to throw it up.
That was a real climax right away.
I just came fast.
Yeah.
It's all over my pants.
What if people weren't listening yet?
Yeah. Well, I mean,
you have to remind him after every commercial break. If you're back, it's Dan's announcement that he's leaving in a week, 2 weeks.
Fall next week.
Yeah, next week.
We probably should re-announce every commercial break.
Yeah, coming back, it's Bonfire, which I will be leaving.
On one commercial break, it'll just be Bobby when he comes back.
He goes, hey, how you doing? I'm Dan.
Format change.
Hey, Dan. I wear wrestling shirts, dude.
I
love wrestling, dude. Yeah. So we'll give you,
to talk to this.
We'll talk it through. Jay and I are still fucking buddies. We're best, he's one of my favorite people on this earth.
Are we back to just buddies?
Yeah, dude, we're acquaintances.
We're just down?
We're in each other's phones.
I'm going to get shot down now.
No, dude, here's
Dan
the thing.
Dan believes I'm a genuine racist. He doesn't want to be associated anymore.
Because of my new religious beliefs, I have a guru I've been working with.
Fucking Lefty Dan?
And New Hampshire. Not even that. It's so far off the map, you can't even fucking tell. Now, I think we talked a little bit about it on Thursday, Terminator Timeline, but it got to, about back in May, came to Jay and told him that I think when the contract is done, I just feel like it'd be the right time for me to leave the show and for you to keep going, which we always knew you wanted to do. I knew you wanted to do that, and you knew that I wasn't going to probably stay around forever, but not in like a shitty way, in like a very honest friend way. Like,
no,
hey, I don't know if
the whole crew knew. We just never believed it. We'll be like, every time we have another contract, we go, Dan's saying he knows.
Yeah. Jay and I talked back in May, and the crew knew back last year in May, and we've been doing the show knowing that this day was coming. That's why I just wanted to throw it up, because we've all known, we've been dealing with it for like 10 months. And then
I have been, the amount of people I told.
Yeah.
Is for me it's nothing short of a miracle that my big mouth has not put this out. No.
I told some people, and I was like, and then I would worry. I'd have a lot of anxiety that someone was going to go and say it.
I never worry. I always just tell people secrets and then assume they're going to keep it a secret, even though I keep my secrets.
I heard he was talking about with somebody at the bar at the stand the other night where I was like, what? Why are you talking to her about this? It was just somebody that, it was somebody that we know, but somebody that, not secret time.
Danny.
Yeah.
Oh, no, Danny. She's...
Yeah, man. I didn't realize how hard this was going to be until today, which how much I've, like, I understand this is my decision, but I'm still very sad about leaving the show. And also at the same time, I'm sorry for bumming everyone out.
Like, I feel diarrhea shitted four times a day.
Jay showed up today and I genuinely was like, man, when we were going to get pizza in between shows, I was like, I feel fucking terrible that my decisions making all these people feel bad, you know, because I've had
we're gonna miss you, buddy. It's not like
here's just the facts, man. I can't. And I told this to Jay on the phone this past weekend. I can't thank the fans, but also
slow down.
Yeah, I know.
Slow down.
All right,
slow down.
I'm just saying, man.
You're shut out of a cannon a little bit.
Yeah.
I know it's hype, but I mean, like, we should explain the situation. Dan told me this back in May.
Yeah.
Is it? In May, that this is what you wanted to do. We, of course, gave time, you know, before we made that any kind of official, even in our talks, to, you know, said think about it. But I know you wanted to. And then when Sirius came to us with the knowledge and kind of like, you know, what's this going to take? What's the thing? And you have, you know, listen, the best way I've described it to people before, why I can never be, one, angry with you at all, nothing but love and, I guess, buddyhood.
I'm gonna get Corey Hamed in Jay's biography. He set me up, dude. I don't know. I didn't want to sound too gay.
We're buds still.
I was gonna call you my brother, and then I'm gonna call you a bunch of gay stuff.
It's not like I'm not gonna talk to you when I see you or something. I'll say hi.
I know, but I didn't want to. You, like you said, I'm shot out of a cannon, so I'm like watching the wrong steps. Where I'm gonna be like, I just want to kiss the guy. I don't want to fucking.
No, you got. Listen, from the get go, we've said this. The best analogy I can give that I've given to people, which has also made them kind of be like, okay, you know what I mean? Like, I hear that. Is I want to be Howard Stern. You know what I mean? I want. That's what I think. You are. I use the example Trey and Matt.
Yeah.
You want to be Trey and Matt. You want to write cartoons. You want to write scripts. You want to get things made. Television space more. So like, I'd be a shitty friend.
Yeah.
I'd probably just be a downright buddy if I said that.
Dude, that buddy thing's going to haunt me. When I get the first text back after I leave of Jay being like, hey, buddy, I'm going to be like, is that because of the thing?
When I fuck with crowds, though, they're like, is this your best friend? They always go, he's my buddy. I'm like, wow. Okay.
I was like, damn, poor word choice.
No, but I know that's what you want to do. And listen, we went years beyond what I think your initial thought was. You said we thought we were going to do. About three.
I thought
you
we
said
were gonna...
we'd probably max out at five, is what you always said.
I always thought it was going to be.
You thought you would want to be done by five.
I always thought we were going to get fired by three. I was like, all right, well, they're going
to
can.
They tried
our
to fire me twice and won.
They did. You escaped two near deaths, and then we just went. And it was like, in a way, like, I didn't think. We went from two
my
days.
Balancing board is going away, dude. I'm going to say something crazy. Black Lou's going to go to HR about me. I don't even know what it's about.
Yeah, but there was, you know, at the beginning, it was like, oh, yeah, we'll do this like a couple of years. And we were lucky, man, going on 8 years, like close to eight, a little over 7.5 years of doing the show. And it's always stayed fun. And I think that was part of my thought process was like, I want to leave while this is still great. While this is still very fun, while
she can go on Larry King and I'm like, now when the show got canceled, what got canceled? It was the most popular show. You remember that? Yeah. Larry King called him out the wrong thing.
Yeah.
What are you talking about? It was on top.
It didn't get canceled at all. We walked away. But there is like, you know, I wanted to. We've seen so many radio duos just go down in absolute flames.
Yeah.
And it was like, man, I just love
Dan's getting out before I yell the N-word at a tourist in Times Square for
I don't need Jay
mad at me taking a picture.
I don't need Jay snapping photos at 3 a.m. fucking making all of us lose our income.
Jay, what did you just tweet?
Jay, you
I was angry.
I don't know. I blew off the steam.
Blowing off a little steam.
But I, you know, man, this has been so fucking fun, and I love this show. And the thing that was the most important to me when I told you back in May was that this show keeps, like, keeps going, because it's a whole crew. It's just friends hanging out. And when you said Bobby Kelly, I was like, dude, that's fucking perfect.
Yeah, so as far back as, well, it's also before I knew Bobby was getting weight loss surgery, I was like, let me throw Bobby's hat in the mix, because, like, it'll make him feel good. He's probably going to die before it happens.
I get to do the gesture.
Little did I know he'd already had stomach surgery.
He's like,
and he's getting ready to get in. Then I made the promise to him already.
Hey, Jay, I don't want the cash. I want the annuity. Dude,
yeah.
I want the yearly annuity, oh, dude.
Dude, Fenoya was right in the fucking pocket waiting to jump out.
Fenoya was banging together a fork and a knife.
Yeah.
He had a napkin on and a shirt going like, oh, it's finally breaking over.
He's going online seeing Bobby shrink, and he's like, what the fuck's going on here?
What's going on? No. Something's got to be broken.
What the hell is this? I thought Bobby was going to die before the thing happened.
It's going in reverse.
No, I asked Bobby, and I say, one of the first things that made me feel okay about this, because it was very, very concerning, and so many friends on the show that I had to consider, like, what do I do moving forward? Do, sure, I go do a solo show?
Yeah.
Do I, where I have, you know, then Sirius also, they have their ideas that I rotate guest host in, and I didn't want to do that because I think for the fans, you want to find a consistency that, yeah, they're going to enjoy and they're going to get into. And what I'll never forget with the Gil, the guy who we did our first run of these shows with,
yeah,
the Soda Shop.
Yeah.
When he took us out for burgers after one of those shows, he described as people want radio to be like religion.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So you got to give them, it's either going to be me and like friends like sidekicking, or it's going to be me and like I have to find a partner. And when I thought about partners on a show, the people that rang out to me, several names obviously came by, all the good buddies, but like Joe DeRosa,
yeah,
I have such a history with.
You guys also have that like buddyship in a way that, like, you know, we have, there's elements of our relationship in both of those guys, but with,
sure,
with DeRosa, it's like a real, you got a real like smoking cigarettes on the side of the comedy club shit.
Yeah, yeah. Me and Joe just go back. He was my roommate at one, yeah, point too. So it's like we just have this great history and a great connection. And to Joe's credit too, I'll say the reason that it was him and Bobby and, mm-hmm, Robert Kelly, who I thought were the two people I can do that for each one their own reasons. With Joe, and this is, I think Joe's got such a good thing with his like kind of his connection now in the world, like with Sal.
Yeah,
Taste Buds is fantastic. It's a great show.
Yeah.
Joe's hitting the road again. He's doing stand-up a bunch. And I was just like, I don't know if it's like, if you just stretch him that thin.
Yeah.
I think the Sal connection is great for him. I mean, he's got such a huge following, Sal. So if you know, Joe can go in and like pull that audience and really like draw something from it, I think it's great.
Also, Joe's hilarious on the show because his like particular brand of shittiness.
Yeah.
Is funny when it's against chocolate chips.
Exactly. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Right? Arguing over.
It's a lot when he's talking about
salted versus unsalted butter.
Yeah. Ukraine, Russia. It's a lot to hear, but when you're talking about pralines,
he's talking about like, yeah, right. Schmuckers or
boom,
exactly.
Boom.
It's my one of my favorite drops. But yeah, man. I mean, Joe's so fan.
It would have been great for us, but Bobby, in my mind, was like Bobby won. I know we respect each other greatly as dudes and comics.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, we also have a great chemistry, a good rapport, and 20 years of knowing each other.
Yeah.
And Bobby loves broadcasting. You know what I mean? He's doing his own thing and stuff he does with Calta. But this is different.
Yeah.
It's a different kind of show, and I think Bobby is going to blend in great. And I do say this to the audience listening. The show moves on with everybody else. Black Lou, Jacob, DJ Lou, Christine is not going anywhere. Christine's not going anywhere.
What if I just show up in a wig and I'm Christine one day? Can we do that?
Are you going to bring that up, Christine? Do you want to take Christine for your next project with you or something?
Yeah. No, but just I like that I'm sitting in because I miss it so much. I'm like, Christine, why don't you take a day off? Why don't you and Dawkins go to the park? And then I go,
do you want Mexican food tonight?
And she's like, Christine, you're an idiot. And I'm like, shut up, Jay.
Yeah. Don't call me an idiot.
I'm not a fucking idiot.
We can't even get Jacob to laugh. He is just staring
down. He laughed a little. We got him to break a couple times.
He doesn't love it. He's not loving it. But yeah, so Robert Kelly came in and I said what my you know, statement to the audience would be, you know, hang in with us, man. We're going to keep bringing you a fucking hilarious show.
Yeah.
And we need the audience to take the ride with us, man. We really do. We've got a time here that gave us a contract to let us come here and establish me and Bobby doing the show now together, and I'm really excited for it. I mean, Bobby's fucking hilarious. He's so good. He's so good at broadcasting. And, you know, we've had him in here for his people have speculated a little bit because, you know, Bobby, it was semi.
That was on purpose.
But I'm saying, but it was also semi, like, you know, noticeable. A little on the nose.
Yeah, people are going, like, what? So every Tuesday, Bobby? And you go, yeah.
Yeah, we should have
till this contract gets signed. Absolutely. I mean, and I will say, as like, you know, the amount of guilt that I have leaving the show and like feeling bad about leaving the show, when you told me, you know, because I had heard some of the ideas, and again, it wasn't my, when I told you I'm leaving, then it's like, it's your show, and, you know, do with it. But when you were like, I think Bobby is going to come in, I was like, dude, that's like my older brother being like, oh, my other older brother is going to come in. And I was like, oh, I got like, I was outside your guys' apartment when you told me, and I was exactly like, oh, yes, yeah, I love that, because it really is.
Well, I hope, you know, we told Sirius when they spoke to another, you know, like Sirius, you know, they're a business, they got to do their thing. And
we told Big Jim,
they were like, if we don't figure out, you know, Bobby right away, like maybe we should do the guest host, and they brought up again. Or we announce Bobby when Dan is gone, like officially, or the Dan's last day. And I was like, yo, there's going to be a feeding frenzy if you don't announce something that's going to make people
at least understand where the show is going.
And pleasantly, like, you know, a pleasant surprise on bad news.
Yeah.
Because they, everybody, and I mean this, 100% of people who I've, you know, had to break the news, I'm like, yeah, Dan's done March 1st. And they're like, oh, man, like, no. And I go, it looks like Bobby Kelly's going to come jump in for him. They go, like, oh, that's good.
Yeah.
Like, it's good. Like,
yeah. And almost, that's exactly how
almost
I
almost not even saying, like, they're not even taking back, like, the that's bad. They're like, that is bad news. Goes, oh, but that's like.
But it's also good.
Yeah. Like, that'll be go, great.
They go, bad, but good.
Yeah.
It's like when you lose a player in sports and then they sign a big free agent and you go, like, okay. Team going to look a little different, but okay.
I give you some fun behind the scenes things that are great. When I went, you know, I said most comics I've told, worked out with them, and I was doing a podcast run out in L.A.
Yeah, to promote the special coming out in April.
Yeah, I was doing a podcast run I did when I got to Greg Fitzsimmons, who I love Greg, he's been on the show before.
Fitzdog Radio, shout out Fitzdog Radio. Greg's
Fitzdog
one of the,
Radio.
Dude, he's one of my favorite human beings and a hilarious comic.
So funny, dude. He comes up and he was like, he asked about the bonfire, and I'm like, oh, he goes, and we started the show, he goes, bonfire, I gotta tell you, I've done it, I listen every day in my car. He's
well, if like, Greg, you're listening, sorry.
He's like, I love it so much. And he goes, and the thing about it, why I love it, he goes, you and Dan are just like an unbeatable team. Like the way you guys just broadcast is, it's just, you're amazing. You guys are really making, he goes, as a comic, I've been broadcasting forever, and I find it hard to like, when you go, it's like hard to jump in with you guys. It's like intimidating because you guys are so good together. And I was like, yep,
oh, dude.
Sure are, bud. I didn't tell him. I didn't have the heart to tell him. And then when I was driving to the next show, talking to Christine on the phone, I told her that, and we're just both like, fucking Dan.
Yeah.
I felt like, fucking Dan, I hate him. I felt slide that. Things off the table and pound.
I felt
stupid. They're so stupid.
I felt that way at Skankfest when Jay and I would be walking around, and they were like, and Jay was doing a bit where he's like, Jay was making me laugh. Surprisingly, Jay was making me laugh while I felt fucking terrible.
Well, because I was trying to make you laugh, because I know the one, I made that joke after, very specifically, a guy and his girlfriend came up to us, and they always do this, the girl selling out the guy.
Yeah.
So I was like, hey, this is my boyfriend. He's too much of a queer to ask you to take a picture, so will you take a picture with him? And we're like, yeah, of course. And we're on either side of him, and he was like, you guys, you got me through some really bad things. Yeah. And he was just like, he was started bawling. Yeah. He started crying, and his girlfriend's even making fun of him for it. He's like, I can't believe I'm crying like a pussy.
It was so sweet.
And it was so sweet. And I just said to Dan, I go, Dan, from now on, every time somebody does that, I'm going to be like, hey, man, I understand. He goes, he's leaving. He doesn't give a shit. Yeah. He could care less about you. Jay, I go, but I will never leave you.
And I was feeling genuinely terrible about that. And then we'd be like bumming into people at Skankfest. And they'd
Bonfire
like,
rules. You're like, Dan doesn't think so.
Yeah. And then Jay wouldn't even say it out loud, though. He'd just he'd like point to me and give like eyebrows. Yeah, yeah. And I'd be like, I'm sorry.
Yeah, well, this guy over here, talk to him.
Man, I didn't want this decision to be a fucking overnight decision and just be like, all right, I think I'm done doing the Bonfire. I put a lot of thought into it. And it just became a thing, like I said, that something I felt like it was the right time because they're doing 2-year contracts. And I was like, I just think.
My speculation is as you sleep, Katie whispers it in your ear.
No. She was
until you wake up and you go, I think I want to leave the Bonfire.
She was shocked in a way where I might as well as walked in and be like, I'm going to bleach my hair and move to Miami. And she was like, what's up? I was like, I think I'm going to leave. She was like, all right, let's talk about it.
Yeah. You guys are on the verge of a new place, too. Because I'm a new place. Cut my income down a little bit.
Yeah. My mom did the same thing, and my grandma doesn't care about me. But no, she does. She's
She doesn't care about the show.
My mom was like, what? And then my mom did the thing of like, so how are you going to make up for it?
My parents asked like, if Dan's okay.
Yeah. I was like, I'm going to go on the road? And she was like, oh, okay. Because Trish, you know, she gets some direct results of this show.
Oh, yeah.
So she was like...
She goes, because the washing machine's a little on the fritz, Dan. You go, well, it may take a few more weeks for that.
She was the only one that was like, I was like, why am I explaining this to you? I don't live with you, lady. Katie was like, yeah.
Well, as long as you got your rent in.
Katie was surprised and supportive, and then fucking my mom was like, and then like Nate was like, oh, okay. When I told Nate, he was like, all right. And then like we talked to Shane, was like, what for? Like all my friends had different reactions. And it was like a thing that... I just, you know, like I said, I was like, I think...
Sick of my shit.
I'm sick of Jay's stupid face. He, A, doesn't let me respect my fitness routine.
It's true.
So I have to leave this to start my Instagram fitness profile.
True. I am not the best fitness companion.
So get ready to follow me at Danny Gaines with a Z. I'm going to be blasting everything from my quads to my delts. And you guys are going to... You guys thought the space hair was bad. I'm going to get facial surgery. You're not even going to recognize me.
Joan Rivers face?
Yeah. I'm going to come in here with fucking...
I don't want to make you feel guilty, but without you here,
I already feel guilty.
DJ Lou is going to die.
Why would you say that? Why would you do that? I can't come back. We were just joking before the show about how I was like, hey, guys, let me back in. Hey, guys, the door shut. Can you let me back in?
Without you evening him out and telling him to read that book every year about quitting smoking?
I mean, dude, I'm going to bother you. You realize what he just put in my head. I'm going to bother you.
I don't know what's going to happen without you, Dan.
Dude, don't you do that.
That was so real.
Don't you do that. Don't you do that, Lewitsky.
I don't think he thought about it until I just made that joke, and then I think that got very real with him. He's like, Dan is the guy that is always like, hey, man, whenever you're ready to knock off the sauce, you know, I'm here for you.
Can I tell you what we just...
I'll never say. I'm just like, yeah, we should booze up on this show. Every time we have bad feelings, let's booze up.
Can I tell you where what I just saw watching Lou go through that is the moment that Lou does pass away, even if it has zero to do with me, is me coming back to booze because of Lou, listening to 10, just pulling out a bottle of Jameson, being like, oh, if Lou was here, he'd be loving this.
Damn.
Don't you put that evil on me, Ricky Bobby.
Yeah. I want to enjoy it. No, wait, never mind.
Yeah.
I don't want you to drink even when I'm dead.
Okay. Deal.
Aww.
Deal. I don't, yeah. How about bother you?
But what if you die because of him?
Oh, like because of an action I do, it gets Lou killed?
Yeah.
I go, hey, Lou, can you go engineer this new tiger podcast? It's tigers podcasting.
Don't you wish you could butterfly effect the results of staying or leaving?
Oh, just find out. Yeah, absolutely.
Wouldn't that be great?
100%.
Yeah.
This is such a gamble. I could be back at Dose in a year. You don't know.
Always bet on white.
I could be taking lunch shifts in fucking 18 months.
Oh, we'll come by on between Tuesday shows.
That'd be crazy. I go, hey, guys, you guys still doing the full show on Tuesday?
You got to do the champagne sword open? Yeah.
Are you guys sabering the Dom Perignon? Hey, Jacob, I love your rugged outdoor look. He goes, it turns out ad sales went through the roof with Bobby Kelly. I go, oh, that's so cool. People probably love two dads discussing
stuff. And then we go, is it weird if we ask the manager to put us at another table?
Yeah.
Seems weird. So he goes, do we tip them good or is that insulting?
Right. We're tipping. I go, whoa, Must have gotten a new contract. I'm going to go roll my silverware.
Oh, all right. Yeah, I'm going to go do my prep.
I got to go do side work. But
can you get a slice of limes?
Good seeing you guys. I guess wave to whoever's working the front desk.
We can do all the free time at first, dude. I'm going to start building.
Yeah, dude. I'm going to go the Nick Mullen route and start doing carpeting.
Yeah.
I'm going to start
your own moving business.
I'm going to get fucking crazy. I'm going to start doing soldering. I'm going to start doing anything I can. I don't know, man. This is a thing where, like I said, we've been talking about it for so long that now that it's actually happening, there's like, I didn't realize how much emotion was going to be behind this.
Very emotional.
I was coke chattering in the first 15, so thanks for slowing me down.
Are you thankful that you didn't do this before quarantine? That would have been a nightmare.
I
would have survived quarantine.
This got me through quarantine.
Yeah.
And there was no thought of
it. No, but I also mean even like financially and everything. We were able to have a job still. That was crazy.
This was, this show's like.
It made us able to sit back and laugh at broke comedians who were going through it at the time.
Starting OnlyFans.
You losers.
Oh, we have justified income and now it's gone.
Yeah. So my idea today
was to let it rip.
Yo, let the phone lines open up, man.
Fuck. I just feel terrible.
So we don't even have to take names.
We should take names and locations in case you hurt me and then I can find you.
We should even take names. No screener, no phone screener calls.
You're gonna go fucking raw?
I think we should go raw dog. Just shoot him through. If you want to call in the show and wishes and say how much you're excited for the new Bonfire with Big Jefferson and Bobby Kelly.
Or if you want to call him, just give me the business.
No, don't just, say that.
Just really let me know how big of an asshole I am.
You're not an asshole. Don't think that for even a second. But
I'm still going to laugh thinking about Trish being like, yeah, I don't know. I just kind of was hoping to bump up to maybe a new forerunner this year and...
Dan's going to sign a partnership deal with Tiger Thick Whiskey.
I'm going to the Schaub family.
Dude.
I'm a free agent. I'm going to the Schaub family. I'm going to bring that up. I'm going to legitimize that.
Is Dan in Thick Boy Studios?
He goes, dude, for life, he got like way into it. I'm full in, papa. Yeah, I'm fucking there.
Dan's full on thick boy.
I'm joining all the... I'm a free agent. Throw your money at me.
Yo, Dan's going mad thick boy.
Dude, Dan, his personality completely changed when he left the show. I'm like, yo, what's up? It's your boy. I did it again. Sold out Albany.
I thought I was going to throw up on the pre-record.
You did a great job.
Yeah, I got through it with my ginger ale.
How are you feeling now?
I feel fine. Like I said, it's such a bittersweet thing. So you consider, I've been lamenting this for months.
I mean, dude, I've
months
had...
and months. We all have. Can and I... then I also have to keep in mind, like I don't have to. I am excited about doing the show with Bobby. I think we're gonna be.
It's gonna rule.
I think it's gonna be a fucking killer, hilarious show. I have no doubt about that at all. It's just the change of like, are the people gonna be like, fuck you or fuck Bobby Kelly?
I think we're gonna get a mixed bag of everybody. I think there's gonna be people that are mad at me. I think there's gonna be people that are sad at me. I think there's gonna be people that are fucking, you know, are dicks about it. I think there's gonna be a lot of sweet people about it.
Yeah, of course.
And I think there's gonna be people that are genuinely excited. Man, I'm telling
you. The anger, as I told you outside, though, and I mean this. The anger is just genuine disappointment. If they wouldn't be angry if they didn't think it was sad you were going.
Yeah.
But they're not going to call up and boo-hoo. They're going to call up like, you're a fucking asshole for doing this.
I would love if the first call was my mom being like,
idiot, what are you doing?
I wanted to redo my kitchen. What are you doing, Dan?
All my sod's dying. I need new sod.
She goes, what, are you going to go on the road for 58 weeks? There's only 52 weeks in the year, you fucking bum. I'm like, there
you
it is. You
goddamn bum.
There it is. I mean,
that's
everyone.
Right. Katie does good for herself, dude. You're doing what a handsome guy like yourself is supposed to do.
I go, hey, baby.
Live off the lady.
Hey, baby, there's a new PlayStation game. And I was really hoping that after I blasted my pecs, if I could take a look at it.
I want Katie to work 80-hour weeks while you're at home blasting your body.
And I go,
it would be great. That's what I said before. If you just came back in 6 months, just in crazy shape.
Joe Piscopo shape.
Just, it looks stupid on you
where,
almost.
Where I'm showing this part, like the bodybuilder shirt.
Wide-necked shirts.
Wide-necked shirts. And I go, Jay, what's up, man? What are you doing? Are you working your core? I've been listening to the show. You guys don't talk about enough core strength. Jacob, my man, did you get that powder I sent you?
He goes, Jay, are you losing weight or am I just getting swole?
Uh-oh. Hey, they should put that metal detector back fucking downstairs because I'm bringing some guns.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah, dude, this is Sierra. Katie left me. She said I stopped being funny and got too rigid. My body became too rigid.
That's great. You just start pumping iron, living off your lady's dough.
I have the cheeks that are like sunken, but then I have bodybuilder face.
Oh, the McElhaney. I swear to you, I was watching old Always Sunny's last night, and Rob McElhaney, he literally worked his face out into not being able to deliver funny the same way.
Oh, man.
Like when he was younger, the whole thing was he was kind of like...
Kind of chubby.
But he wasn't chubby at all. He was just like the most average bodied guy, but like... He dressed almost kind of cool.
Well, they always say...
Dirtbag kind of way.
In the early, one of the early seasons, they go, Mac, how do you see yourself? He goes, I'm the sheriff of Patties.
Yeah, yeah.
I like the way he says it, as a matter of fact. I'm the sheriff of
Patties. And he said his face wasn't fat or chubby ever. Yeah. I mean, he got fat for the show. But sure. When he was just like normal young in the thing, he looked like a Philly dude. But now he's got those chisel face things.
The chisel look.
You can do it. I don't like that at all.
I'm going to come back. Yeah, there you go. I'm going to come back like... Actually, I've been spending my time learning a lot about proteins. And
Dan is chiseled.
I go, hey, can I get Joe's number? I want to talk to him about some different forms, some press.
Well, I told you when I called my step pop on three-way with Justin once.
Yeah,
this is a couple weeks ago. Just to be like, oh, you know what? Let me get Joe on the horn. I'll ask him something about this. Justin was asking about some supplement or something.
Yeah.
He's like, it's been great for my joints or something. I go, yeah, this is a Joe conversation. I called Joe, and then I sat there. Both of them were accepting of me sitting silently on three-way playing Candy Crush on mute, watching YouTube while they just talked.
Really?
And then at one point, I go, boop. And I went, hey, guys, I got to jump in the shower for my show. So
and he goes,
love you both.
Joe, I'm going to send you that stuff. I'm telling you. It's made for dogs, but it's going to change your life. I'm telling you right now. It says only take if you're like, you know, not around any electricity. I don't know why for humans. It's bad.
Did you bring up McElhaney? It's like hard to be funny when you look that like strained faced. It looks like it's got the face of caring too much to be really hilarious.
Yeah, you got to have despair on your face.
Yeah, you can't give a shit too much.
Yeah, I mean, that's why I felt stupid about the science wig. Because I was like, maybe I should have just gone big headed bald. Would have been funnier.
When he was younger,
look at those chiseled cheeks.
Oh, listen, he looks fantastic. He just doesn't look funny. You know what I mean? It's like he's
dreamy.
Yeah, he's worked the funny out of his face.
Do you think that he'll go and get injections? Have you heard that?
Where some filler?
He just comes in with chipmunk cheeks.
Well, you know, she did. Caitlin Olsen did a complete face makeover. Like, she's a different human being facially from when she started the show.
Dude, I can't wait to come in just shredded.
I can't wait. The sucked in cheeks.
And you're not faking it. Hey, Jay.
Oh, are you wearing, t-shirts that are too short? So when you lift your arms, everyone sees there's actual, like, tactile veins in your pelvis.
And little belly hairs. I go, that's pretty cool.
You got that chicken skin because you are tanning?
Yeah. Chicken skin is such a great way to call it. Chicken skin on my fucking neck.
Yeah, but just know also like right by your thing, like it's always, it looks like you always have goosebumps.
Bro, the lady took us to Turks and Caicos. Bro, I did a workout on the beach.
Wow, phone lines lit up. I don't want to see names. Or I guess it's just first names. Huh? Dan Soder, you could have at least announced the Bonfire departure and Pooh Bear voice to soften the blow.
Looks like I'll be going. And looks like Winnie needs to leave the forest.
It is. I have no other way to describe it other than Dan Leroy Jenkins, that announcement.
He came out, dude.
I mean, it was so, all the information at once. And Bobby's coming in. And dude, I was like, I'm just going to make a whole like speech about Bobby coming in and my process of picking him. And,
I'm sorry, dude. I'm bad
and
at
him,
radio.
Thank God, wanting to do it.
I'm bad at radio, dude. I got to get out of here. I suck. I'm going to go home.
I think every night I'm saying when I asked Bobby about his interest in wanting to do it at all, and he said to me, he's like, 2,000%.
Yeah.
And I remember that as a quote, so I was like, that was the first thing that made me go, like, oh, maybe there's like a light at the end of this.
We're gonna
like,
win.
Dark shit. Yeah. And that really was like, I feel like as much as I hope Bobby feels like this show is a great move for him and his career, like he's in my eyes saving the show in many ways and my ass, and I can't thank him enough. It's gonna be great.
Yeah.
The audience take a ride with us. And our audience is very understanding, right? Let's just check in with Michael from Washington.
Hi.
Yo, Mike, sound off, dude.
Oh, crackle, crackle, guys.
Crackle, crackle, buddy.
I'm legally not allowed to say it anymore.
Yeah.
Oh, well, my my bad, guys.
No, I said I'm not. You can say it. You should say it.
Both of you have got me through some really low points, just being able to sit in the car and laugh out loud. I fucking love you guys.
Well,
I'm happy for you, Dan. I'm sad. The biggest thing is I'm going to miss the voices, man. If you could just, before you sign off, for once and for all, if you could give me a Biggie Smalls, because I can still go back to the tapes and listen to you ordering cheeseburgers as Biggie.
Oh, yeah, baby.
Thank you so much.
Bonfire family. Yeah. Man, here's the thing. I've been actually working with Jay for months.
Just Michael, so you know, I could do a Biggie Smalls. Why don't you pick one of the ones I can't do?
Why don't you go fucking Macho Man or Dangerfield?
Yeah, on Legion of Skanks, I'm Biggie Smalls.
So I'll be reprising that role. Like you stepping in and going, actually, if you could scoot it over to me. Here's the thing, the description that I think the reason everyone feels so good when they hear Bobby Kelly stepping in is because the description of our show is like people listen to it like it's friends hanging out, and Bobby and you guys are...
Of course,
You know what I mean? You guys aren't buddies, but you guys are friends. You know,
we're clear. We're dear friends.
Damn, I really did throw out the announcement, and I'm sorry.
He goes, don't worry, man. And just listen. Hey, this was Dan. Hey, everyone, I'm leaving the show. Bobby Kelly's coming in. Don't worry. Me and Jay are buds. That was one sweep. That was he used a Grim Reaper scythe to chop the heads off of the whole room.
Sorry, I don't throw up eloquently, Oakerson. You know what? Next Wednesday, I'm out of here. I'm going to just lord that over your head the next week.
I think, you know what? You I know only got to get through fucking three more days of this bullshit.
I got another four shows of your shit, and then I'm fucking gone, dude.
And then, man, damn, dude, of all weekends that I plan to get a Dan Soder tattoo on.
Oh, fuck you, dude.
This was going to be the one. Michael, thank you for the call, buddy. I hope you stick with me and Bobby. I'll teach Bobby voices.
Dude, Bobby, you get a whole new thing. He's got a different octave.
Oh, yeah. We could do some different ones, like Horse Shack.
It's just ones that people don't understand because they're too old.
It's too old, exactly.
George Jefferson?
Mr. Wilson from the Jeffersons?
we can do the whole slate of ABC in the late 70s.
He does like the older brother from Mr. Belvedere, the one that people thought was Marilyn Manson.
Yeah. He does a good Ricky Snyder when he was on Coast Guard Silver Spoons.
He plays the guy who played the Bo Duke's cousin.
Yeah. He can do the whole cast of Hey Dude. Including Danny the
He
Indian.
Does a Danny Cooksey. That'll knock your dick in the dirt.
I swear to God, you're going to think you're watching an episode of Salute My Shorts.
Wow. Let's see. Who else should we take? Pick one at random, DJ Lou. This one's on you.
Gary, Chicago.
Gary in Chicago? Is it Dan's Gary?
On fire. Bittersweet to hear the news, man.
Yes, indeed.
Bittersweet's a good way to put it.
Dan, I'm going to be seeing you in March, and I'm going to give you the fucking business.
Yeah, I
straight
know.
Up Rocky Carlin all over your stage, dude.
Yeah, dude. I expect it.
Yeah.
Trying to get physical. I'm sticking with you and Bobby to the end, bud.
Oh, thank you, Gary. I appreciate that, man. Yeah, I think it's going to be. Listen, Dan, what did I say to you on the phone last night, buddy?
Fuck you, why are you doing this?
No.
You ruin everything good in my life?
No, after that, when I calm down. No, I'm talking when I calm down. I go, why are you doing this to me?
Jay.
I was like, no, it's fine. It's fine, dude. I guess it's fine. No, I told you, man. I was like, go write TV shows and put me in them, man.
Yeah, absolutely. That's
don't fun. Worry. I'll just take some time off from the bonfire if I have to shoot something. I won't quit.
Oh, low blow, dude. Low blow.
Yeah, I'm going to call your mom tonight and tell her. I goes, hey,
right,
I stuck in there.
Trish,
I'm gonna go, Trish, what do you think Dan's doing?
Trish is going to be like, I wish you were my son.
She goes, what do you think Dan's doing?
Oh, it's him and that average cock. You just got to his head and made it think it was so big he could make a move like this.
Dan big dicked me. You know what's funny? I used to tell everyone he had a big dick. He would say he didn't. And then he came in and big dicked me.
Trish goes, you're telling me. I mean, I birthed him, and let me tell you. Eensy weensy.
Eensy weensy. I said it is a bittersweet is a good word because that is the thing. Yeah. Like, I have under, I mean, this moment is all this right now. But I said there is a thing where it's like, dude, it's going to be really fun with Bobby. Like, even just, you know, it reminded me of when me and you first got the show and we thought of the name and then just like the giddy nature of like the beginning of it, like, oh, well, these things, and just like, well, who knows what, you know,
it's, you know, it's a
shows, how many live shows we've done now together. I also love the what I'm going to miss the most. This is going to be sappy emotional, but it is kind of cool. We both have our own identity in comedy for sure.
Yeah.
For sure. With things, I mean, I have, you know, other things, even like Skanks and our own stand up and all that stuff.
You know, I legally wasn't allowed to, I did Billions. I got to do a bunch of stuff.
No, but I'm not saying that. But it's a, damn it, I had a good point, and then pot and derailing.
No, but you were talking about that we have our own identities with comedy.
Right. Yeah, this is what I was saying. Yeah, sappy. Is that what was cool, though, was when we were, like, we also, one of the identities was like as a comedy duo in some sort of way.
Yeah, absolutely.
In the sense of like, not only just Bonfire, when we did the Comedy Central TV show they had there, where it was in the topics, goes, well, how about me and Dan, neither one of us wanted to do it.
One of the hardest I've ever laughed was the camera setup of Tonight at the Cellar. What was it called? It was called
This Week at the Cellar.
This Week at the Cellar, whatever it was called. When they were filming, when they were setting up the camera, it was sponsored by Bacardi Limon, and they kept bringing, they're like, we're going to put Bacardi next to you, and I go, you know my father drank this until he was dead. And then Jay and I, off camera, were doing it like I was confronting a serial killer that killed my family in court, where I went, you took the light of our family, and you took it away from us, and we grew up in the dark because of you. And then Jay and I, they were taking so long that Jay and I were making the audio guy laugh by doing heat. We were doing the thing from here.
It was the flip side to that coin. Because they kept making, they just wanted to sit at this table.
And they go, sit at the table, we're setting up the camera, don't move. And then we're like, I feel that heat coming around the corner. I'm gone. 90 seconds, I'm out of there.
If it's between you
and me.
And some schmo.
That's what it was.
Brother, you are going down.
And we looked over, and the audio guy was just dying laughing, and the producer was getting frustrated with us because she was like, "Guys, sorry, one second, and then we're gonna feed you the topics."
And that was the table sitting one. I'm talking about we went on stage though together,
and then
benefit shows and the late great Sarah Dahms thing. They asked us to go on together because she loved the Bonfire so much, and like, so getting to do those, I mean, not that we can't do them anymore, but just the thought thing and the process of people were like, if we can get Dan and Jay together, that's awesome.
Yeah,
because of the synonymous nature of doing the show together.
And
like,
also
I will miss that, because when we did, like, I remember things where it's like, if it was on my own, they were like, hey, you want to do that, was it Wrists of Fury,
or
Caitlin Cook,
Kelsey Cook, and then the
Kelsey Cook's thing. But we
the
did
Marvel
it.
Kitchen,
yeah. Oh, the Marvel Kitchen cooking show.
Upsetting that guy was
that guy
so
did
fun.
Not like us at all. Yet made the most delicious wedding soup I've ever had in my life.
Immediately, I turned him off when he goes, "We're doing the Punisher, and we're going to make something in a compressor or whatever." I go, "Wait, the things that vigilantes make street bombs out of?" And the guy was like, "Yeah." Like that, I go, no, a little two on the nose with Punisher. It's like,
yeah, by the end, he was doing a lot of like, and then we just throw the whole onion, and he's like, no,
yeah,
like you have to
fucking pissed. Mm. But the thing, and again, man, the like, how important it was for me that we're able to leave, like, I'm able to leave, and Bobby's able to come in, and we're, but most importantly to me, obviously, is being able to leave the show on a high note, is knowing that we get to do that stuff still, is like. You know?
And then quietly alone, root for it to fail to prove that you were the glue that held it all together.
And then I go, I just listening every day at the radio being like, a voice would have gone perfectly there.
I think for our next call we should take, and this is good, because it's not going to upset you if it's negative anyway. He's from Canada. Joe,
I'm
fire away.
Going to be in Canada this weekend. This guy might be up there.
I'm spreading the word, eh?
Yeah.
You suck.
Yeah. I'm going to fucking hose you.
Crackle, boys. It's a sad day.
Yeah.
It's a bad
day. I'll never leave you, Big J. I'll never leave you.
Thank you, buddy.
But Dan, I will be there on Saturday night.
All right. Yeah. I'll see you then.
I'm also in the I Can't Smell Club.
So oh, really? I didn't know you're nose blind as well? Well, dude.
I'm nose blind and a Macho Man lover.
Oh, man. I'm going to have to. There's going to be so many me. You're going to catch me in the next 3 months of my stand up after shows is going to be the apology tour where I'm just like, I'm sorry I left, guys.
Sorry, everybody.
I just fucking left. I'm sorry. Fucking please don't hate me.
No, no one's going to hate you.
Your name's Dan, but you're not one of those pussy comedians who after the show, like, bails out a back door and you can't shake the guy's hand or say hello.
No, I usually walk out after. If you wait like 15 minutes, I'm usually walking out.
Depends. I met people this weekend in Nashville, but the first night, I didn't bring a jacket with me.
Oh, yeah.
I didn't know where I was going to be. And it was like 20. It was also freezing in Nashville.
And this is just a rule for comedy. If you're meeting a comic at an early show, when there is a late show, the degree of difficulty is much higher, because a lot of the times where you would meet people is where the people that are waiting for the next show were sitting. So it creates kind of like a chaos for the staff, where you're just like there and like, we're trying to get people sat for the second show, but they're, if they say, they see you there taking pictures, they're like, well, I'm gonna go take pictures.
Saturday and Sunday I popped out.
Late show I always come say what's up, and sometimes I'll pop in early show before the show.
Oh yeah
just be like in the lobby, like,
again, here's the problem. If you're a club now that goes, especially when it's cold out, when it's warm out, I like to go outside and smoke cigarettes because it's warm, you know.
Sure.
But when it's freezing out and they go, you can smoke inside, it's gonna be a low chance of meeting.
Jay's in his smoking womb.
But man, warm out, I'll go out there and hang with the crowd all too much. Where the crowd, where the club will sometimes be like, hey, we gotta like clear people out.
I've been hanging out and been too high before, or when I was in Nashville. In fact, Nashville, I was too cold. The weather dropped like 40 degrees in a night, and I went out and I was able to hang with campers for a little bit. And also, what's funny is the club doesn't understand sometimes is you want to hang after the show and meet people, and the club is like,
they shoo them away.
And they're also like, we have paperwork that you that we have to do, and you're like, oh yeah, but I want to hang out real quick.
But I've had that. I've had them come in there and they go, all right, it's all clear out there. I'm like, no.
God, no. Well, I mean,
we told everybody to get the fuck out of here and move on.
Yeah. Well, Joe, I'm glad you're rocking with Jay, and you know,
and you're rocking with Dan.
And we're rocking. You guys can still rock with both of us, even though I'm not going to be around.
Big Jay up in Vancouver. We need some Big Jay up there.
I'll be up there, buddy. I promise. I'll be getting to Vancouver. No doubt. Last time was canceled. Did I have COVID last time, or was? Oh no. Last time I canceled. No. I didn't know if I was going to get, I couldn't risk getting it up there.
Oh, yeah.
What happened to you?
It was what you were flying back. You canceled Vancouver right after I got it in Winnipeg.
Because you had to stay there for seven extra days, or
five
extra days. And I was like, I can't afford that. There's so much I miss if I do that.
Yeah, I left on the fifth day and I was able to call into you guys, but I had to.
And then what a motherfucker. I think it was a crazy amount of like low days. It was 3 or 4 days after you came home, they changed it.
Yeah, it was nuts.
It was like it was like such a movie-esque timing of Dan came back from those 5 quarantine days. They make you pay for out of your pocket.
I had to pay for out of my pocket, and then I also had to get driven to Fargo because...
You had to escape Canada.
Yeah, so now I'm returning to Canada for the first time of my escape, so bring it.
Dude, what if they arrest you right at the border?
That'd be sick.
Yeah, until they got Lamb of God.
And then I'm just in a Canadian prison talking about how I left a radio show and now I'm in jail.
Let's see, is there a... Well, no women have any feelings about this at all. We're like, we don't even like the show anyway.
Yeah, I listen because my boyfriend has it blaring. Do you want to take a break and then come back?
Yeah. Should we take a break, Jacob? You think it'll be a good thing? Okay, let's take a little fucking break. We'll be right back, everyone.
Oh, you stop it. I've been listening to this song a lot. I don't know much.
And now, back to the Bonfire with Big Jay Oakerson and Dan Soder.
I think in the interest of time, everybody, we should probably, we made a plan today.
Oh, yeah.
To go to Dan Soder's Vocal Academy.
Well, as I depart, I need to bestow this wisdom.
Well, we got to dole these out.
Yeah.
We got to see who's the best at them.
Black Lou made, you're right. Black Lou made a list, and I want to go through, because some of these you already do.
Yeah.
They're in your range.
I mean, Racist Clint Eastwood, I would argue was a dual effort.
Deauville is ours. That's a dual effort.
Yeah.
I would say...
And Buffalo Bill's you for sure.
But Jewish accent is...
A construction worker I could do fine.
Gay accent, you're fine.
But there's
fine.
Some in here that I...
Kevin Hart, we both do.
Yeah. Macho Man.
Old Black Man. DJ Lou Girlfriend, we both do.
Bobby Kelly voice, I feel like we actually have Bobby Kelly now.
Yeah, so we're fine off that one. Jacob voice, we both do. It's almost like the Lewis voice of this show.
Yeah.
I wish I couldn't do that.
Boston accent, we can get Jay there.
Yeah, Russian, Boston, the dialects.
The dialects.
I am nervous about.
Like the African voice?
That's what'll get me. African, I almost think I can get.
Well, the second one, I'd say you already have. Anyways, Lou, hit us with it.
Hit it.
Rich Little.
You know, I've been doing impressions for a long, long, long time. My favorite politician by far was always Ronald Reagan. Who the hell are you?
Sean Connery is being asked whether he would like to vacation in Spain.
Yes.
Christopher Walken sees a magic trick. Wow!
Jimmy Page slammed a door on his finger. That's how they wrote the song.
And of course, my favorite, Jack Nicholson.
I can't believe I ate the whole thing.
Easy, baby. And what's with that sneering crap? Don't do that to the people. They want to like you.
Yeah. I'm Steven Scott. See how that works?
To prevent a major drought of impressions and fun voices, we here at the Bonfire must run our existing staffers through Dan Soder's Vocal Academy.
And now, class, the greatest voice instrumentalist of our time, Professor Daniel Soder.
Oh, thank you, Jason.
Thank you.
And welcome to the Dan Soder Voice Academy. As I leave onto my sabbatical, a journey into the woods, I must leave you with the tools to help the bonfire keep burning.
I feel like I'm the TA in this one.
Dude, first off, dog.
Teacher's assist.
You're not even that. You are a professor at the Dan Soder Voice Academy. Because what we've practiced here, getting our doctorates in voices, was we learned that there's tones and there's groups of voices in tones. A la the Feld Dog, Justin Silver. Also, you could look at the...
If I sing All Night Long, I sound exactly like Lionel Richie, I think.
Yeah. We both do a Springsteen. We both do a Bob Dylan. We both do Eddie Vedder.
Marilyn Manson.
And again, you can look at our library and see where these moments were solidified into voices, especially Feld Dog, Josh Adam Myers, Justin Silver, those family verses.
You have a much more wider catalog as well as ability. And I just told someone recently on one of the podcasts, I had to do the story of like running out of that the voiceover audition.
Yeah, oh my God.
Where
dude.
I said my friend Dan does a Dr. Phil and then did a bad impression of Dan's impression.
I don't even do a good Dr. Phil.
You do a great Dr. Phil.
Everyone knows.
But you...
It's trash.
It's trash. But I said this is Dan Soder's impression of Dr. Phil, basically. And they go, any impressions that you do? And it's like, Charlie Sheen. And I went, I'm the ghost of the most, baby. And then panicked and went, AIDS.
That was trash.
That was trash. And then I got lost in the hallways of the building and couldn't get out.
Dude, that is so fucking bailing on a voiceover.
I had to walk by them three times when they were like, it's fine. I'm like, it's not fine. Stop saying it.
Stop
I'm trying
it.
Not to look at you when I walk by it.
Please let me leave here with some dignity.
Stop it.
Which is any dignity. Well, Black Lou made a list of voices, tossed them all on there, which I love. And then we kind of went through... And, you know, we talked about it. Racist Clint Eastwood, we created that together.
But I wouldn't mind seeing somebody else trying to pull it off.
What do you mean? Oh, one of the crew?
Oh, yeah.
You're right. You know what? We'll keep that back on the list.
The crew's going to have to take a swing at all these.
Well, there's
the ones I don't do, I will take a shot at.
Well, the Bobby Kelly voice, we have Bobby Kelly.
Sure.
So we don't need to do that.
You know what, though? While we're at it, I wouldn't mind hearing everybody do a little Bobby Kelly, though.
Okay, you know what? You're the captain. I'm not going to pull this. I'm the prof, dude. I'm just here to get you. I'm the sensei. I'm just here to get you to the glow.
Yeah, I think...
Jacob's voice, I think... At what point, Jacob, are you going to... Do you think Bobby comes in and just does the Jacob voice and everything's cool?
I think he'll be able to pull it off.
Yeah, I do too.
Jay does it really well. Anyway.
Jay does it perfectly, so we're not missing a beat there. DJ Lou's girlfriend. I'm excited to hear the crew try that one.
Yeah, but I think we should go right down the list and audition everybody.
All right.
I'm bad. I don't want to do this.
And then at the end, do you want me to give tips on how they can improve their... Do I do that person by person? Or at the end,
yep,
machine gun it?
Well, first things first, I see we just see who does it first. You got to give them a little taste.
Okay.
And then
a little example.
And then I'll take the second swipe at it.
As always, do you do your first take impressions? By the way, sometimes they're fantastic. You do, and this is, I've said this on previous episodes, you do the best Charles Manson.
It's not a Charles Manson.
I know. But I'll tell you what, it just works. It just works. Christine, are you excited to try these?
My stomach's flipping. I've got so many butterflies.
Look at the two thespians don't want to play a little acting game.
I thought you were great at Shakespeare.
This ain't Shakespeare.
Yeah, I know. This is silly
it's
time.
Way harder than Shakespeare.
It is way harder than Shakespeare.
So I'll do the voice.
I don't know what to say. Also, like, you guys are. Not only you can kill whatever, the voices, you, can say whatever you also there's say no, funny there's
no,
lines.
But there's no failure here, because Jay and I are here to catch you.
You know what? I say we go around the horn,
mm-hmm,
and it'll be a conversation of voice. Dan will ask the first question, which I will then throw to you.
Yeah, we'll do a little
and
improv
you will
game.
Throw to Black Lou, who will then throw to DJ Lou, who will then throw to Christine.
And we'll see who can do the voice, and then you know what I can do is I can knight you with the voice, and then you're the voice. Right. You're the one that does that voice on the show now.
Watch how easy this is, dude. I thought we
were going to imitate what you said. Like, you were going to say something, and we were going to repeat it back.
We can do that if you would like. If that's bowling with bumpers.
Sorry, Christina. I must have grown a production bone recently and figured out this is the funniest way to do it.
Yeah.
Maybe you didn't hear my family history, but I can't look at Black Lou and say racist Clint Eastwood to him.
Well, that's
you don't have to say something racist. You're gonna ask Clint a question.
Eastwood. Yeah.
As racist Clint Eastwood.
Yeah.
Yes.
Like, we're gonna send Dan's gonna ask me something.
We're gonna teach
I will
you how
answer,
to do...
and then I send the question to you.
And we're gonna
question.
Teach you how to do the racist Clint Eastwood. It's not just saying something racist. You got to find something funny to say that could be taken as racist.
Mm-hmm. Jacob, we're going to make this so easy on you. Okay. You'll see. Why don't we just send this one around the horn?
And I just had a finger up my ass less than 4 hours ago.
I just got molested hours ago. He's already back in the game.
For money. I paid money for that to happen, and I'm going to teach you.
You got your fox hunting jacket? You're good to go, man.
You're good to go. Some of these
you
voices...
look like a millionaire who's going to try to sexually molest wrestlers.
Yeah, and by the way... yeah, dude.
Fucking Jacob DuPont.
I love it, dude. I love your fox... What is it?
It's a good look.
Fox...
Foxcatcher?
Foxcatcher.
Team Foxcatcher? And some of these are going to be... I might whiff on some of these.
Mm. So, Dan, you shoot me a question.
Yeah, which Jay's here.
I will answer.
As the TA.
And then shoot you a question. You will answer, and you'll get it by that point. You'll ask Black Lou a question. And then Black Lou will ask DJ Lou a question.
So you're just trying to do the voice. Don't worry on what you're saying. You're just trying to do the voice.
Okay.
We're just seeing who can do the voice. I just need to pass all this stuff on. Because there's going to be bits... that I'm not going to be here for anymore, that you guys need to continue
I feel
on.
So much nervousness from Jacob and Christine and Lou, and I got to tell you something, guys. You're going to be humiliated if this goes bad.
Can I tell you
all
who's...
Right, I just want to make everybody feel good.
Can I tell you who's really bringing some energy right now that I like is Black Lou.
Black Lou is so ready to jump in on this.
Yeah.
He can't wait.
You're not nervous, huh?
Playing it cool, that's all.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
All right. Are you ready?
Buddy, I'm so ready for this.
I know,
this.
You're the TA. I'm just looking at if you're ready. Fucking classes in session.
So we're going which way?
Dan's going to ask me.
Yeah.
Dan's going to ask me a question. I will answer in the accent. I will answer in the accent, then ask you a question immediately after. It'll be quick.
Mm-hmm.
You will answer that question, throw it over to Black Lou. Black Lou will answer, throw it to DJ Lou. He'll answer, and then throw a question to Christine. Christine
will work
answer
our way around
the question.
And then we might flip the order, you know? We might. Who knows? Got to keep you on your toes.
We'll see who's panicking the most.
Yeah, we'll see who locks up. Now, the first voice, not an easy one, but a fun one.
This is a brutal one.
It's a brutal one.
I always love this one.
So we got to start with the African voice. Oof. Now, I would probably say this is more East African than West African, but it's just in the way you ask the questions of, like, who are you? That's all you have to do.
Yeah.
You know... Just imagine, yeah, you're going to lock up on this one. Jacob.
No, watch. Dude, let's just start it.
I need you to be calm, Jacob.
Send it to me. Ask me a question, Dan.
I want you, what did you have for breakfast today?
Oh, today I did not have breakfast, but I had a little bit of an Italian hoagie. Jacob, what kind of people do you want least on your lawn?
I can't. can't do an African. Please
don't make me do that. Jacob, what?
Do not answer my question.
Jacob, do not answer my question when I ask you the question.
It's so bad.
Jacob, what is Toby's African name?
His name is Kunta Kinte.
All right. Now you gotta ask Black Lou a
little question.
Who do you not want on your lawn?
Oh my goodness, I don't know. But if I'm going to say someone, I'm going to say white people.
There you go.
Because they don't give a shit about your lawn.
I mean,
they don't give a fuck.
Black Lou showing up, dude. Black Lou showing up.
You gotta ask DJ Lou a question.
DJ Lou, I have a question for you. Why are you not longer called White Lou anymore?
Sam Metna. I can't do it.
Yes, you can, Lou.
Say, man, it ain't cool being no jive turkey this close to Thanksgiving.
And now a question for Christine.
Christine, where you at,
what
girl?
What the fuck was that? Lou, what did you do?
Trading places.
Trading
places.
What did you do?
Hey, my
it
man,
ain't cool
what did
being
you
no jive turkey so close
Lou,
to Thanksgiving.
Lou, what did you do? That was crazy.
And what did he ask Christine? What it looked like? Christine, your African answer?
Did you say where you at?
Yeah.
I am right here.
All right.
Where are you at?
At least you tried, dude. Lou changed it. Lou changed Lou, it.
Hey, man, out. I don't know.
Black Lou, you on that. And rightfully so.
For sure.
You know, to make the show not get fired. African accent.
Lou
Black
didn't
Lou
even try.
Dude, I don't know what I don't
say
know what DJ
blood.
Lou did.
That's what you said.
Yeah, you should have had say this hey, this hand motion with it.
We should jump right to
Can
Clint
you
Eastwood.
Dig it? I knew that you could.
We'll come back to number two, but racist Clint Eastwood, which is obviously both of us built that.
Yeah.
So that's and it's just racist Clint Eastwood just talking through your teeth in a certain kind of tone.
Yeah.
And then you just need to find something that sounds racist. Hey, Jay.
Yeah?
What happened since all these VHSs moved into the neighborhood?
These ass clowns have been bringing down the property taxes.
Yeah.
But they're driving up the crime.
I'm telling you, these loose farts, they're ruining all the restaurants.
Jacob, who do you want least on your lawn?
These ninnies. They're ruining. Is that a bad word?
No,
I just hear you
no.
say it all the time.
It's fine. I think someone said it's racist black, but I've always just thought of it as insensitively gay. So I don't know if it's any better that I don't think it's what it is.
I hope.
You got the voice,
funny.
Though. Get
now you have to ask Black Lou a question.
Ninny. Ninny means foolish person.
It's
foolish
person. Totally acceptable.
It's a noun. In case you're wondering.
I don't know the question.
You don't know what question?
Yeah, just ask him a question. Is racist Clint Eastwood?
Freezing up.
You just ask him any question you want.
Black Lou, is that shirt for you, by you?
Yeah.
Lou. I can't. There's a reason you two are good at this.
Oh, come on, Jay. Come on.
I'm trying
ask
to think
him
of
he...
something. These ninnies won't let me give me the time.
Come on.
Lou, just say something to DJ Lou. I got nothing.
Black Lou, this is going great. This is
I'm
even funnier than I thought it was going to be.
I didn't know it was going to be this funny.
I knew really it was going to be funny, but this is above expectation.
I know my lane.
No, dude. I think you had it
Don't
more
you
than
dare.
You. I think you had it more than
You're
you
doing
knew
fine.
You had it.
Go ahead, Black Lou. You asked DJ Lou a question.
DJ Lou. What is your least favorite minority?
Like Freddy Krueger.
Dude, I'm so glad I'm next to Black Lou.
Whatever sugar boogers are on my lawn.
Okay.
Christine, who are you inviting over here to this house?
I like it, dude. DJ Lou's, I liked it. It was a little bit of a Wolverine from X-Men, but it fucking
it's
worked.
It's actually an impression of my dad.
Oh Lord.
Less racist.
Christine racist Clint Eastwood?
I'm not going to be inviting... Wait. No, that's not it. That doesn't sound like it at all.
Oh, Dan. Dan Service Voice Academy.
Dude, okay.
Yeah, wait.
I certainly won't be inviting any of the ninnies over to my house.
We really piled on the ninnies.
Yeah, dude. Ninnies are really taking a beating today. Dude. Oh,
I didn't want to say
my face hurts. Oh, my God.
I think
God.
We jumped to Boston. Some of these I want to hear so fast.
That's
now
what
that
we got.
Now that I see it. Now that I see it falling to pieces.
Well, I'm also writing who does the best one. And out of me and you don't count. No. And I think out of the crew, I would have to give it to DJ Lou. Racist Clint Eastwood.
Yeah.
Lou got African accent. DJ Lou gets racist Clint Eastwood. No surprise on either.
Jake and Christine still to get on the board.
Still got to get on the board. Who do you want to see next, Jay?
Well, we can get Christine a free point and do the Valley Girl. This is a mood because that's a girl. She's going
to
take
that. And that's not really, that's one that anyone can pick up.
I beg to differ.
You think?
That. We could try it. It's all I've grown up around.
Obviously, we're just doing very basic white girl voice where it's like, honestly, I'm like freaking out right now. Jay, aren't you freaking out?
I am totally freaking out. Jacob, what the fuck? Are you even picking us up for the mall or what?
Oh my God. Sure am. I don't want to do this.
I don't want to do this.
What's X?
Oh my God.
This is so great. Oh my God. This is so great. We're just going to keep going. We're going to the end. We're going to the end of this.
Oh, my God, Lewis. Do you want to go to Banana Republic with me? This stuff fits me so well.
I actually find Banana Republic to be a little disgusting, and I'm really into, like, Abercrombie hair. It's really fantastic. DJ Lou.
My puss is literally sweating right now. Christine?
Christine, what?
How is your puss, girl?
Oh my God, like my pussy's totally fine right now. It's not even sweating. You're disgusting.
I mean, you can't even. And honestly, though, DJ Lou gave her a run for her money. I didn't, just purely on what he chose to say.
Yeah.
Black Lou was there with the voice. Jacob, you were you showed up.
I thought that was my best one yet.
I don't know, dude. I think your racist Clint Eastwood might be your best one, right? But yeah, Valley Girl.
I think Boston. I'm not good at Boston, so.
Well, we got to get you there.
I'll try.
Because it's going to come up, and also Bobby's from Boston, so you're going to have to do those.
I know a lot of like, hey, Bobby, when you were younger, the guy said this.
Yeah, you need a lot of those.
Okay.
And this is one, again, you're a TA, you're going to pick this up. You're on level 8. This ain't a 101. This is a fucking 401 for you. This is 404 for you.
Fire it at me.
So Boston accent, it's just eyes are the ones you want to lean on, you know, just mess up your eyes and say, you know, what are you, rock hard? You know, it's all vowels and eyes.
You think my cock's rock hard right now?
Rock hard.
Why is my cock rock hard, you think? Because of the pictures from the cocks?
Your friend Todd is rock hard.
Jacob, your fucking cock's probably hard from all that rock hard cock.
You bet your fucking...
Nope.
Dude, it's the snap.
Boston. Bet your fucking ass. You want to go to the Sox game with me, Lou? I hate this so much. I hate this.
This is my worst accent. I don't.
Sure.
Yeah, dude. Some of these are going to be brutal.
Yeah, let's park the car.
There you go. Okay. You can say what you need to do. You want to ask DJ Lou a question?
Lou. Are you going to pack the car? pack it? Pack the car?
You going to pack the car?
I just feel humiliated.
Jacob, listen, we got to do this.
Guys, this is part of the growing pains.
This is going to hurt, but it's going to lead to so much great stuff.
I never thought I was taking over voices when you left. Entered my mind that I
Michael
would be
Michael Jordan didn't
voices.
Make his high school team first.
He was cut. Ooh. He was cut from varsity.
Yep.
Yo, Christine, you want to go see...
What the fuck? Dude, Lou's Bale is my favorite thing in the world.
Lou and Jacob Bailey?
Go see a Sox game later.
That was my line.
It wasn't terrible.
That was my line.
Christine, do you want to go see a Sox game later?
Sox?
Yeah, Lou, I'll go see a Sox game with you.
That's
Brooklyn.
That was Long Island or something.
Jay's got that. You're going to be the one that's going to have to carry that. You're going to have to carry that torch. Can I ask for one?
Sure.
That I saw on the list? Uh-huh. Dude, this is... I'm sweating from laughing, dude.
Sweating from embarrassment.
You got me laughing like fucking Bert over here. I'm squealing. DJ Lou's girlfriend.
Okay.
Now, it's basically just a fiery Latina. Jay and I have played around with it several times.
DJ Louie's going to go,
honestly, Jay, I'm just waiting for the whole turnaround. I'm just waiting for him to come around to him. But it's just basically anywhere from a Rosie Perez to a shut up, stupid, to a
you can make it a little your own.
Yeah.
A spicy female Latina.
Whatever comes up in your mind is that. You know, you don't have, there's not like an actual voice you have to copy. It's just more of kind of like, Jay, why are you so stupid?
Because I am stupid. Because you know I ain't go to school. That's why I got my GEDs. Jacob, what do you think? You're so cool because you went to schools?
Why are you looking at that fucking bitch? I'll stab you in the fucking eye. Make me some fucking mole.
Mole!
Mole, dude. Mole.
A question for Black Lou.
Oh, I kind of went because I only had something for Lou. I don't have anything for Louis.
Just toss an easy question to him just to pass it on.
Lou, you looking so fucking fine in that hoodie, man. Make. Won't you leave? What?
You just gave a compliment and didn't ask a question.
Won't you leave that pregnant wife of yours and go with me?
Good question,
Louise. Ay, por qué eres mala conmigo? Lou, why you lie about where you at, stupid?
Great.
Pendejo.
That's great.
Carajo.
He's coming out with Spanish.
Negrosito.
And Black Lou might just grab another one off the fucking pile right here, dude.
Fuck you, twin. Oh, I can't do it.
Jesus Christ.
It's not coming out Spanish.
Fuck you, twin.
Fuck you, twin.
Fucking twin.
Dude, I'm hogging up phlegm.
You did get the emotion.
God damn it. Dude, him pulling back always is funny.
A question for Christine, Lou?
I can't do this. I can't do this.
Where you going tonight? Drinking?
Yo, you stupid. You know I don't drink anymore, so I don't get all fucked up like you.
Pretty good, Christine.
Not bad.
Christine, that was pretty good. I think I'm going to give it to Black Lou.
Yeah.
Black Lou came out with it and hit the Spanish.
I actually thought I did well there. My mole line.
It was good.
Mole line was killer.
Killer, dude. Killer. But just Black Lou, as far as shouldering the responsibility, we got Black Lou.
If Black Lou had to take over the role, he's throwing Spanish in there.
He's
doing
just got
hoopla.
It.
Yeah,
he's just got everything together.
He's loose.
Yeah. I'll do the racist-y one, and then Black Lou can do a more legit version.
based on a true story voice.
Yes, he's based on a true story voice. Yeah.
Jay's more like a, cartoonish.
Listen, let's talk about one of the biggest or two of the biggest holes that we're going to have here is, of course, Macho Man and Rodney Dangerfield.
Oh, there you go.
I think we have back-to-back, we have to do those two.
Yeah. Do you want to do them at the same time or do you want to do, let's do Rodney first because Rodney's very, it's just low register. She got this. It's just a lot of, you know what it is? A lot of jiggling, a lot of, hey, you're moving around a little bit. Hey, I'm telling you, Jacob, you're going to get this voice just fine. Hey, look at Jay. Everybody's getting laid. You got that. You know the quotes.
Send it to me, dude. Send it over.
So all you got to do is, hey, Jay, when's the last time a lovely lady came over?
Oh, I don't even know. They never show up anymore.
Boom.
Hey, Jacob, you getting laid steadily at all?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Dude, this is maybe my favorite moment of the bonfire in 7 or 8 years.
Hey, how old are you?
I'm 37. Oh.
Okay.
I went through a fight last night and a hockey game broke out. Lou, you ever been to see hockey?
Hey.
I leave my wife everywhere. She finds her way home.
It wasn't terrible.
Dude, DJ Lou surprisingly might right now, outside of you, have the best one.
Hey, Christine. Blah, blah, blah,
I ain't got no respect.
That wasn't bad at all.
Christine, showing up. All right.
I think it's safe to say that.
You do the best one. But I think outside of you, I might go Christine.
Christine would be the most fun one. It'd be fun to hear a girl doing a Rodney Dangerfield.
Yeah,
it was close
like,
enough.
Hey, I'll tell you. My
Give me one more. Give me one more. Get no respect.
Hey, I ain't got no respect.
I don't know why I love it, but I do.
I love it.
Hey, when I have a period, it doesn't show up for 3 days. I breathe, I'm bleeding air. I got nothing going on down there. It's a jet stream. I'm telling you.
And now?
This is the I'm telling you.
Macho telling you. Man.
Now, Macho Man's gravelly. Got to hurt your throat a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
Because what you got to do is you got, you know, like do that noise.
Yeah.
You like a dog growling.
I'm still reeling
do
over
it.
My Rodney Dangerfield.
It's all right. We're going to move forward.
I meant to do
forward.
A line from Easy Money and it bombed.
But Jacob, do a. Yeah, there you go. Yeah. There you go.
You're leaving for. Living to do your thing.
Yeah. I'm okay, taking off. I like where Jacob is going. So you stay in the gravel and then you come up real big. And then you go back down, yeah. And then if you can, you whisper. You whisper sweet nothings in her ear. Right, Jay? What's gonna happen when the shit hits the fan?
Well, first I'm gonna talk in a really low register.
Yeah.
And then I'm gonna bring it up.
Yeah.
When it comes time to bring it big, and then I'm gonna go back down because you never know where it's gonna come. Dig it!
Yeah, call him Rand McNally because he's got the map.
Jacob, oh my. Questions. Can you dig it?
Question and answers.
Bring it on. You think you're the voice instrumentalist here, is that right? You think you're gonna take this championship?
I don't know.
Sucks.
I've never watched wrestling before or heard much of Randy talk. Lou, are you a wrestling guy?
Oh, yeah, Miss Elizabeth. Oh, my God, DJ Lou. Christine?
Yeah, you can ask her a question. You just keep thinking it's Christine's question. Christine?
It takes a lot out of me.
Oh, fuck, dude. Christine!
Well, you heard the man.
We're gonna miss Dan Soder so much.
We love
you.
That was a good one, Christine. Christine's
good.
Christine, you're coming through in a way that, I'm telling you, is impressing everybody.
Thanks,
Dan. Doing good. I'm going to have to give that to DJ Lou for the pop.
I mean, for
sure.
Dude,
the pop. Dude, that got me.
Comes in big and angry.
Just came in big and angry, but everyone did real good. Jacob, you did a fucking good job on that one.
Where did I rank him amongst the four?
Out of the four, I would probably go DJ Lou, Christine...
Oh.
I'm sorry. You, Black Lou, on that one. But hey, the thing is you're
climbing.
Getting better. Yeah. You're gaining confidence.
Yeah, I'm getting
so
my
the next
legs.
One, the next one's a classic one that everyone knows that Jay's I think already has is on the precipice, which is former California Governor Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Sure.
And it's an easy one to get into because, Jacob, all you have to do is just say the of course.
It's my favorite one.
Of course. That's how you get into it. You're not going to get a good pump unless you stretch. Of course. You're going to hurt yourself. Jason, when's the last time you've blown out your quadriceps?
Well, you know, I do it every day, of course. Of course. Why wouldn't I not do that? Jacob, are you blasting your quads every day?
Mine's is pretty bad.
I never heard that one out of you, and I was like, let's hope we find one in the four, huh?
Jacob, save it.
You need to do upper body and lower body, Jay. I see that your glutes are looking really firm. Have you been working out your glutes? I can't do it. It's terrible.
You just asked about your ass.
You've got to believe in yourself, Jacob. Come on. You can do it.
Let's just retire this one.
No, Jacob.
Man.
Say it.
I got it a little bit.
Jacob, what is best in life? To crush your enemies.
Jacob, show
to
me
hear
your
the
room.
To crush your enemies, see them driven before you, and to hear the lamentations of their women. Come on, Jacob. Do it. Ask Black Lou a question. Come on.
Do you... Louis, do you feel strong? I can't do it.
You did it. You asked me if you feel
strong.
Yeah,
I asked a question. That was...
Black Lou, I know it. Deep down inside of you, there's an Arnold Schwarzenegger. Bring him out of you.
There's no Arnold Schwarzenegger here.
Come on. You're the only one that can change the last name to have the N-word in it. You can do it. Say it. Arnold Schwarzer.
Arnold Schwarzer player.
Yeah, that's fine.
That works.
That works too.
Just fine. DJ Lou, will you come with me to the chopper?
Are we looking for John Connor?
Christine, I want a mega mix of his bales.
Christine, have you seen John Connor?
Why is he holding his nose?
Of course. I have not seen John Connor.
That was dog shit. I'm not gonna lie.
Holy guacamole, that was a tougher round than I thought it was gonna be.
Maybe Bobby can do Arnold.
I don't know. I thought Let's pray to God. Oh, I'm breathing different.
I'm sad on that one. Nobody pulled that off.
Yeah, we don't have much time.
I'm happy just retiring that one now.
Let's pick the ones you really want because we got about, I don't know, 6 minutes to break.
6 minutes, dude.
6 minutes till we have to break?
Yes, sir.
Oh, fuck, dude.
And then will we come back and have?
I'm fucking sweating.
A minute?
Then not much.
I'm sweating.
Yeah.
You want to break now and finish up?
Yeah, we'll do a couple when we come back, see how much time we have.
Okay. Let's take a break.
I am having fun at Dan Soder's Vocal Academy.
Dan Soder's Voice Academy is going off brilliantly. You guys are all doing such a good job.
Shit is bumping, everybody.
Yeah, this is... Oh, fuck, dude. My face hurts. We're going to be right back. It's the bonfire.
Legit feel awful, dude. It's terrible.
And now, back to the bonfire with Big J. Okerson and Dan Soder.
Welcome back to the bonfire, Sirius XM Faction Talk 103. I'm Dan Soder. That's Big J. Okerson. This is the Lost Tapes.
We should probably wait for Bobby. I thought this was Bobby sent this to me this weekend. But, dude, Carlos Mencia, did he send this to you at all?
No.
It's Carlos
Mencia. That's cool. You guys are doing show prep. You guys are getting
it's
ready.
It's Carlos. Yeah, we just stay in touch. Era. We just stay in touch.
Yeah, no, it's fine. I definitely didn't try to call you.
I tried to call you
talk
after.
Talk about this.
I tried to call you after. It was so late. I don't know where the hours went with me on the phone.
We just gab.
We just go. Just point us in direction and we go. I've heard this weekend he was doing 4 hour, 4.5 hour sets.
Yes. Because that's what the world needs.
Yeah. Well, if not, his friends all die.
Yeah. He's like, you guys don't understand. This is like a fucked up situation.
If I get off stage and go haywire.
Because, man, I made a deal with the devil back in 02, man. Rogan was right. I was stealing jokes, bro. And then the devil came and said, I can make you the greatest. And I said, what do I have to do? He said, you have to stay on stage or everyone you love dies.
I got off for 50 minutes and my friend Martin.
He's dead. Yeah, dude, that's fucking 4 hour shows. Anything over 60 minutes is crazy.
I mean,
70 maybe if you're like, damn, this hour's cooking and I gotta cut some of it.
I've never understood marathon comedy.
Dude, one time Wolf was like, I'm doing 90 minutes. And I was like, that's rude. And I had to say that to her. I was like, that's fucking rude to the crowd that you're doing. It's sucking it. It's like when you bust a nut and a girl keeps sucking, you're like, okay.
Yeah. About an hour and 15 in, I'm going to be like, okay, it's ticklish. It's ticklish. Don't touch it.
That's what the comedy on it's like. It's like, dude, stop. I just want to eat something now.
Wait. Still sensitive.
You made me pop so hard back there with your closer. I thought that's what was the closer.
You remember like Dane Cook and like Dane Cook ordered pizzas for the audience? The Chappelle thing. That was the beginning of the like self-righteousness of like Chappelle kind of like clouding some of his like legacy. Is that, yeah. I mean, one of them was like six.
Yeah, which is
and
crazy.
Then Dane Cook had to beat it with like 6.5 at the store.
I'm gonna pay, at the comedy store or Laugh Factory.
And at one point, he just ordered pizzas for everybody. They go, isn't that cool? He goes, it's dumb. The whole thing's stupid and self-serving.
It's so self-serving.
7 hours.
I've brought everyone pillows and blankets. We're all gonna take a 4 hour nap together, and then I'm gonna wake up, and we're gonna have juice boxes as I break down it capitalism.
It's less crazy that. Andy Kaufman brought everybody for milk and cookies. Yeah. It's less crazy to do that than to stay on stage for 6.5 hours.
Yeah, Steve Martin walking the whole audience to McDonald's is
It makes much more sense.
A classic bit compared to doing 6.5 at the Laugh
Factory. Is that a regular thing?
It was for marathon? A while. It was a thing for a while. Like back, it was like 05, 06.
Was it? No, it was later than that. I feel no. Was it around then?
It was right. Before I moved to New York. It was the tail end. That was 07 because Chappelle would do like 2 or 3 hours at the Cellar.
Started doing 4 hours like more recently than that though, like maybe around 2014.
I don't know. Maybe he's just always been doing that. But the Chappelle, someone told this story. I forget which comic told this story about Chappelle and Dane Cook.
Mm-mm.
Dane Cook like ran the Laugh Factory.
Mm-hmm.
It was like, you know.
Yo, that was his club.
It was his club. And he was like on top of the world. And Chappelle was in LA and Chappelle wanted to do a set. And the owner was like, yeah, you can't. It's like Monday's Dane's night or whatever. And Chappelle's like, oh, I just want to do like 10 minutes or whatever. And they're like, yeah, well.
I just want to do 10 minutes every half hour on the hour.
I want to do 10 minutes in dog years. That's 17 hours of comedy. So he told, he was like, yeah, you can do a set, but it has to be tight or whatever. And the story is that Chappelle went on stage and was like, hey, I don't normally do this, but I'm going to sign autographs for everyone out front. I'm going to come take a picture. And the audience was like, oh, we'll go out front and meet Dave Chappelle. And then Dane Cook was, I think, up after that.
Really?
Fuck, did I hear that pod? I might have heard that story on a podcast. So I just remember that story being like, what a move.
Yeah, to be like, get the audience to leave afterwards.
Yeah, you know, I'm gonna go out, and I don't usually do this, but I'll hang out front and fucking sign shit.
Those marathon sets, I remember at the Cellar at one point, they'd be like, if you leave, like right when he gets on, like I think you were sacrificing your pay.
Really?
Possible. No, I may be wrong about that.
Because they were.
Whatever it was, they would almost ask, maybe it wasn't sacrificing your pay. I don't want to put that stink on them if they did that. It was more like, wait, hang on.
Because he might only do a little bit.
Right. And then by the time we started seeing, and then staff. Dude, the staff, all the pretty girls in the staff just had like bags under their eyes because they're there till 6 a.m, 3 nights a week when they're supposed to be home by like 4.
Yeah, I remember a couple times the radio, when he was doing the Radio City Hall shows, mm-hmm. he was like, me, List, Norman, and Andrew Schultz sat there and watched him because we were on the late show and we're like, oh, we'll watch Chappelle. We all got bumped. And it was like Rock and Chappelle. And then they told me, I left at like 2:30, 3 a.m. and they were like, oh yeah, he was there till like 5. And you're like, on a Wednesday? Just on a Wednesday.
And it's like, oh, the people there feel like they're a part of something. Like, yeah, they are. A long night of little sleep to ruin your next day.
Everyone's tired because Dave just wanted to keep talking.
I would be willing to say, if I had to just like keep talking for 4 hours on stage, I'd say by hour 2, you wouldn't enjoy it at all. My laughter would be over. I'd be over it. Over it.
By hour 3, it'd be me just making noises. I'd just be like, whoa. Just be concept album shit.
I feel like that could get me. I feel like that would send me back to being like months into comedy and that feeling of like, I don't have anything else.
I mean, it's
to do.
If you want to spin it in a positive way, it is a testament to Chappelle that he can stand up there for 4 hours and by hour 4.5 be like, I'm still funny. And you're like,
self-indulgent. And I don't, that's my point. I don't know how funny it is at that many hours in.
But what if this?
I'm not talking about not trying to say something funny. I think most comedians like speak.
Yeah.
Like funny as like language, you know what I mean? If I'm arguing, I say the funniest words if possible. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So it's not that. It's just like, I think I couldn't give the oomph or the whatever. I would feel like I don't think I'm doing them a favor by staying there for 4 hours. I'd go, I'm so sorry I'm putting you through this.
That's exactly.
I'm going to try to make it as funny as possible.
Just self-aware Dave Chappelle. You go, I understand we've been here for 2.5 hours, and everybody wants to go home, but I'm not done talking about me. I love me. One time I woke up and I said, I look cute this morning. And everyone's like, it's fucking 4:30 in the morning. I would kiss myself if I could.
If I could.
Yeah, did we find the first? We never got to the first clip of this guy.
Oh my gosh, I just said that.
The at-home comedy studio.
Are we not saying his name on purpose?
I mean, people will find it. We did this with...
No, I've said it before. Say it before. I don't know how to say it. It's Pete something.
Yeah, we did this with Lynn where everyone was like, we can't expose Lynn. And then everyone found her. And then this guy, everyone will find him.
We didn't expose Lynn. She asked to have her thing. She made her
thing. She sent nudes.
And she gets all... it's 99.9% the most wonderful comments.
Yeah, and didn't, and you got to see her husband's penis.
Yeah, you we get to take did. A look at his pecker. Yeah, oh, I didn't look, Jacob. Ew, dude, you're ew. So fucking gay. I didn't oh even realize God, you looked.
Can you believe you looked?
I'm surprised you, of all people, didn't comment.
Wow. Wow. Okay. Okay. Thank
wow.
you, Jacob.
Wow. He's saying you're a little too much about the flesh.
I didn't even look at this thing yet, Jacob. You studied it.
Wow.
Jacob.
That's me. What were we going to say?
I'll marry Black you and fuck Jay.
I feel like you were going to say something about Lynn.
Yes, she hit the Bonfire DMs up asking if she should purchase merch.
No. So
purchase merch? No. No, first of all, she's not going to purchase merch. We would send it to her for sure. Yeah,
dude, please send out. A, Lynn, if you hear this, please send a laundry list. She goes, oh, want. Merch? That's crazy because I was going to buy this. Four hats, four sweatshirts, some pajama pants, a nighties.
No, we'll get it all too. We'll get her some shirts. We'll get her some hoodies. We'll get her the panties, the Bonfire butt plug.
Yeah.
The Bonfire collaboration with Hitachi Magic Wand. The Bonfire.
It'll be my last act on the. It'll be my last act on the shows to overnight all of it.
Bonfire dental dam.
I'll go out giving you guys a gift. I go, goodbye, guys. I'm going to mail this to her overnight.
Take this to the mailroom, please.
Yeah. Dan, on, your on your way out, can you drop by the mailroom and send this to our spokesmodel?
I think I think the stamps are enough.
Yeah.
I think there's enough stamps. Stomach is it not. Bro.
Really? Because of Tuesday?
Yeah.
Yeah. I've been anxious as shit about it.
Yeah, I know. It's funny to kind of give people a little insight.
Yeah, our live show.
Timeline.
Yeah, on the live show Tuesday, we announced that I'm leaving the show March 1st.
About an hour and a half from.
Yeah, but I think it's going to be, I don't know, man. I keep being like, it's going to suck.
Yeah.
But I just hope that there's like.
Hey, well, our audience is great.
Our audience is great. And they understand, you
they're
know.
Hanging in there.
And if they're mad, like if they're mad at me, if they're, you know, I get it. I do get it.
You're just going to be disappointed. Yeah.
Yeah. Well, apparently you're bored.
I'm bored as shit of this show. Yeah. This show needs some Bobby Kelly life.
I'm glad you're spicing it up with Robert, with the new skinny Robert Kelly.
I don't know. I just feel weird as shit.
Well, it's like we've done so much of this, and also I think, because we talked about it on Tuesday, you know, this is something that I brought to you back in like May, and the crew has known forever.
Yeah.
And Jim knew, you guys set up the new contract. We've gone through all of it without really talking about it to the audience.
Yeah.
And so that's why it's getting real as fuck today. Because it's like, we've operated knowing that this thing is coming.
Yeah.
But it's been like, oh, I'm leaving in May, I'm leaving in March, I'm leaving in March, and then now we're just right there, and we're like, so I'm leaving in March?
Yeah, I know. It really snuck up.
There's a lot of, like, you know, and I've been talking to the crew about it, there's like a lot of I'm having a very mixed emotional time doing it, because it's my choice, I left, so I understand people, that's why I understand people being mad at me, but there is a thing of, like, I'm sad as shit. Because I love you guys. Like, I love this. I love hanging out with you guys. And then there's like a mixed bag of like, but I'm also excited to
not deal with Jacob shit anymore.
Yeah. I don't want him browbeating me constantly for the choices I make immediately.
Pussy.
Yeah. That was almost perfect level. Breath. That was a perfect volume level. You know, oh man, I'm gonna miss drops. I'm gonna miss so much stuff, and we're hours away from actually announcing it. So that everyone,
not even,
yeah, we're less than hours away.
I'm shocked. I told Rebecca today, I can't believe that it didn't get like out.
I'm glad it didn't.
I'm glad it didn't. But I was
Jay,
really
especially with me knowing the information,
yeah, well, Jay,
dangerous.
Well, Jay, here's the thing is, and this is obviously we can break down all the walls because I'm fucking here. When we originally all knew it was happening and the process had started moving or whatever, I was like, well, we'll announce it in January or whatever. And you very wisely were like, no, we're going to do 2 weeks because then we can still do the show. And it's not. And that was
don't
such a...
Don't let them lament too long. Don't let the crowd lament too long.
But what I want to say is that was such a good decision because it was able to be like, we all knew it was coming and it was like this awkward thing that was coming. But... we were able to have like a lot of fun shows, and we were still going to have another week of fun shows.
This guy this weekend in Nashville was like, "Dude, I told you, they were like the game. Guys, through so many
God,
times and blah
feel,
blah blah.
It makes
like,
me feel terrible.
I love you guys so much, man. It means so much to me." And I was just like, "Listen to the show on Tuesday, big announcement.
Yeah, there's one coming. just have some tissues by her or something to punch.
According
just
to,
real quick.
According to DJ Lou, it might not be much of an announcement because he's been he told us, Lewis and I, he's been getting drunk and telling everyone at a bar.
Oh, okay.
One time.
We should have known that was the leak. Yeah, really. I mean, for 8 years we've been doing this. We should have known the leak was going to come through fucking...
A lot of comics knew.
I told, the only people I told, you know, like the people that I told early on were like Nate Vecchione, obviously, Shane, and then...
So you spoke to Stavros about leaving a show?
I spoke to Stav, because Stav left Cumtown and I watched what happened and I was like, hey bud, I'm going to have kind of a thing like that.
You called Opie, see what that was all about?
I go, Opie, when you guys broke it, no man, the reason I, we did, I, the reason, and we talked about this on Tuesday, I didn't want us to end like that.
On your last day, though, you should say something racist.
Oh, dude, if you don't
And then
think...
we're going to be like, Black Lou, I'm so sorry that happened. Dan, you're fucking out of here, dude. Like just like that.
Honestly, and what's going to do is it's going to give me a little
street
momo,
juice?
A little juju coming off the show.
Oh,
so if we
you.
Could just kind of blow this thing up at the end, just to send me and then you guys are fine and there's no damage to the house.
Proud Boys, Dan's going to be performing in Vancouver.
I go, I'm going to tell you why the vaccine was a hoax. Catch me in Ontario, California. Yeah, it's we're about to, you know, have the live show and fucking talk about it, and it's
I'm gonna throw up.
No, you're gonna be fine. It's
I'm gonna throw up.
I keep doing this thing of like sentimentally putting my badge in my pocket when I leave.
Aww.
Where I'm like, come on, buddy. Oh my god,
look at your little picture
left.
On the badge.
Yeah. There's like a lot of stuff. There's like a lot of stuff where I'm like, and again. For those of you that are like, but you're the one leaving, I understand that. It was like, this wasn't an easy thing.
Are they going to deactivate you?
Yeah, 100%.
You can deactivate
I wouldn't
that.
Be, honestly.
Jacob's going to cry.
No, Jacob's doing the solemn nodding. But Jay, I wouldn't be surprised if there's an outside chance I can't get into the building on my last day. Because it technically is the first and my contract is up the 28th.
I have to put Dan in as a guest.
Can I tell you the weirdest moment that's going to be? And obviously, there's going to be some time passed where we're going to be able to process this a little more. But the first time I come as a guest and I have to wait in the lobby. And
for them to come get you when it's the right time.
Yeah. That's going to be weird as fuck. Is them being like, hey, and then just Black Lou coming out being like, hey, buddy, you know, like that fucking lobby energy. There he is.
And you realize when you come in, like, I have to treat you like an ex-husband to some degree, too.
Well, we already did a bit. Me and you already talked about the bit we want to do when I come back where we're like, me and Bobby are arguing what Jay likes more. Actually, Jay likes it a lot more if we watch this. And Bobby goes, dude, things have changed here a little bit.
Yeah, I go, Dan, I don't like that anymore.
Yeah.
I like different things now.
And I go, Robert's
Since
making...
you left, I've grown to love different things.
Oh, let's stop. Let's just get out of here and do a sixth and jump. I mean, let's just really get out of here.
Turn away into a sixth and jump.
I mean, come on, there's so much Seebach material.
We have three full seasons left we haven't watched.
I mean, let's really make it work. Give you the Bill Murray.
Give it one more try.
Oh, you still got that good stuff.
Can we give it one more try?
I mean, there is, you know, Jay and I spoke about it on the phone, but there is, I'm very, and I said this on Tuesday, I'm very like, I feel like very lucky that I was able to leave the show in this way. Where it was like, the show's going to keep going. I'm going to come back as a guest. It's something we've always talked about, that you wanted to do radio. And I just wanted to do a show with you. I just, you know, coming up in comedy.
Until you didn't.
Yeah. Until the money wasn't there.
I just looked in the camera for Black Lou. What do you say? He goes, until he didn't want to be anymore.
Until the religious and creative freedom wasn't there anymore. Nah, but it's...
Since we're terminating your timeline, what do you think? I say we open the phone lines up today.
I think the reaction's going to be so raw and shit. That maybe tomorrow.
I think that's what makes it funny.
I think we maybe. Yeah, you're right. If you want to yell at me,
no, not just yell.
Call and yell at Dan.
No, I think some people.
That does sound like a fun segment. And by the way,
I think some people are going to call and be like,
"I was raised by an alcoholic mom. I can deal with this. Call and tell me I'm a piece of shit. That's what my own brain does all the time.
And it's not what they're going to do.
Yeah, you guys can call me and call me a fat-headed fuck that's leaving a great thing.
You're giving yourself the biz there, dude.
Dude, I do this every day. And people, dude, I promise you, there was outside of Katie only one other girl I've ever dated where they were like, Do you talk to yourself like that all the time? Katie, when we got together, she goes, I'm mean to myself, and I'm impressed with how mean you are to yourself. And I was like, it's a nightmare.
Did you, at any point,
all the time.
At any point since you made the decision officially, because you were pretty firm on it from the time you said it.
Yeah.
Well, you never wavered, but behind closed doors, could I have
all
you,
the time.
No, I'm saying, have you been like, shit, maybe this is a mistake to leave?
I waver between that and, yeah, almost every day. Almost every day I'm like, fuck, dude, we've worked so hard to build this. This is such a fun thing. It's so easy. But then there's a part of me that's like, yeah, man, I just felt like it was, we were at a Skankfest South in Houston, and you and I were talking at the Ellis event.
Yeah.
And that's when I was like, what if I told you I was like, maybe nearing the end? And you went, buddy, whenever that is. It was so heartfelt and warm. It made me feel so good.
Yeah.
I really enjoyed the rest of Skankfest until I fucking bombed on the Lewis roast. It made me be like, oh man, it was this warm moment where we were watching Skankfest. And I go, what if I told you I was like kind of near the end of it? And you go, buddy, whenever you are, you just tell me and we'll figure it out like right. that. And I was like, oh, all right. Because that's when I was like starting to think about it. But I've wavered every day.
Just being realize you've hated the show so long.
Dude, yeah.
I always stare at Jacob because I know he'll get sad, but with me.
I know, I hate the show at all. I love doing the show. I just felt
just
like...
not that much?
No. Honestly, and I probably said this on Tuesday, I genuinely thought we were going to do the show for like 3 years. Yeah. I genuinely was like, oh, we'll do this show for 3 years. It'll be fun. And then, you know, fucking we'll have this thing. And then it's just been great. And then we did eight years, you know? We did most of a decade.
Oh, yeah.
And decades?
And I always knew, and we always talked about it, I remember one lunch we were at with Comedy Central where like we had a discussion and I was like, yeah, I want to do this for a little bit. I don't like radio. I got fired from it. I'm like, fuck radio. I was like, yeah, I just want to do a show with Jay. And then I remember the Comedy Central people were like, how long do you guys want to do a radio show? And you go, forever, like that. Yeah, and I go, not that long. Like that. And then there was a thing that we've talked, and you know, like Christine and you and I have talked about it time and time again, every time there's a new contract where it's like, I never wanted it to be the thing of like, we're doing this until we can't do it anymore. I was like, I want to do it for a limited time. And I love what we've been able to do. And the fact that the Bonfire carries on with Bobby is in a dream scenario. It's a dream scenario.
I don't want to overkill this now because we're going to actually make the announcement. Yeah. We're going to repeat ourselves a lot.
Yeah, but you know what? I'm going to be gone soon, so drink it up.
Yeah.
Also in that note, do we have the...
you made your decision. You turned your back on the office.
Yeah. I mean, I felt like that, you know.
No.
I felt like that a couple times.
I mean, without giving stuff away, I know things you want to do and stuff, so it makes sense.
I can't start my fucking, you know, I can't start my OnlyFans without you.
Yeah, the Dan Soder Methadone Clinic.
Oh,
you know,
my
that's
God.
A big dream of yours.
Yeah, I want to bring solace to Aurora and get him off the needles. I also want to do...
You're going
to
build your own voyeur motel?
I want to do comedy for Greenpeace. I want to do all bits, but just live out bits from the Bonfire in real life.
All weekend, just say, I will say... All weekend, Josh is such like a single guy.
Yeah,
like no girlfriend for so long. He wants to believe so bad. He goes, "Is it Katie making him do it?" He goes,
what
I'm
the
like,
fuck?
I'm like, no,
that's the dumbest shit I've ever heard.
No, it's not. It's not the dumbest question. Is it something like she would want you to stop? But I'm like, she goes on the road for it. No, listen,
nah.
If Christine could snap fingers and nothing changes financially, but I don't have to go away 7,000 times a year,
yeah,
she would. So it's not a crazy thing.
No, Katie was super supportive when I like did it. She was like, really?
But just saying Josh is doing it, he goes, is it Katie making it? So I'm like, no.
No, Josh. No. I like that Josh, like, if I would be in such a bad relationship if she was like, leave the show, and I was like, yes, mama. Yes, mama, let me make that call. Hell no.
But no, he wasn't digging on her at all. He was just asking if, like, because he doesn't know what the reason, you know.
I mean, out of all the scenarios I've played in my head, I'm like, dude, I just really hope there's not a bunch of fucking dudes being like, fucking Katie made him leave, because you're like, that's so retarded.
Well, I'm glad I brought it up then. She didn't make him leave. Wink.
Yeah, no, she had zero. Man, you know what's funny is when I was telling people about it, when I like first told people about it, they were like, really? Like a lot of responses were like surprise. Everyone was surprised, including Katie. It was like, really?
Yeah, you know, I don't think you would leave because she wanted you to leave necessarily. I don't think that would be the easiest decision to make because your girlfriend wanted you to leave, your fiance even. But DJ Lou, if Michelle said leave the show, he'd leave tomorrow. He doesn't want to get hit again.
Yeah, we just show up, it'd be an empty board. And yeah, he goes, I beat you to it.
He goes, she says I can't.
She says I can't do it anymore.
She found out girls work at Sirius. She thinks everyone's going to want to fucking suck my dick.
I'm also not allowed on the internet no more.
Hey, DJ Lou.
Shit, that's so funny.
Yeah, man. Well, Tuesday, I promise you, Tuesday hopefully went swimming. And maybe we do open it up for calls.
I think we should open it up for calls. Why are you saying that, Black Lou? What are your thoughts?
A lot of them are going to be. I mean, I'm not going to let anyone who's not positive in.
Why?
Why? That's funny.
That's the whole thing. Oof. Funny. I go, what do you call that? What is Bennington when he does that?
Mm-mm.
No, like no phone screeners.
Oh,
no,
just phone screeners, fucking just raw, through. Dude. Just
give a name.
In. Just give a name and location.
You just go, you're on the bonfire, go. And they just say whatever. A nameless, faceless comment. They just gonna say whatever
listen,
they
man,
want.
Listen, man, they already got a new contract. I'm out. Let's fucking do it. It
doesn't matter now.
It doesn't matter. I'm going to be a former employee in next week.
Burn it down.
Burn it down.
It is cool, though. Well, the good news, I mean, they gave us full dental medical this time.
What?
And vision.
What?
Yeah. Pretty crazy. They came off it finally.
I did. There was a moment where you told me about the deal, and I was like, oh, yeah. That sounds so great. I go, I think, well, I really hope you have a good time. What's that Myrtle's talking to me?
Didn't you probably get another job for 8 hours a week to pay you doctor money?
What if I told you guys?
That's easy enough, right?
What if I told you guys that Myrtle made me leave? I'm going Son of Sam.
He's going Son of Sam. He goes, Myrtle keeps telling me to kill, and I can't when I'm in this mainstream job.
Kill!
California!
Kill! Like the dog in the movie.
It was so much worse than I remembered it from the theaters. Kill for me! Kill!
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 Who voiced that dog? Tom Kenny?